Today, we're going to be talking about the transform pivot point in Blender. I'll press Shift A, and then under Mesh, I'm going to choose Cylinder. We've talked a little bit about pivot points already in the origin point video tutorial, and to edit it, you can just come up to this little button here called Transform Pivot Point. The first one we'll talk about is Medium Point, which is the default. This will make it so when we have our one object here and press R, you can see it's going to rotate around our origin point. If I press Shift A, and then under Mesh, I'm going to choose Cube, and I'm going to press G and Y and move this cube along. Then, if I then shift left click my cylinder, and now I press R to rotate, you can see rather than rotating from the origin, it's going to rotate in the middle of these two objects, which is why it is known as medium point and not origin point per se. However, if you wanted to rotate the object of these two objects using both of their individual origin points, we can switch it to individual origins. And now when I press R to rotate, you can see it's going to rotate it based on each object's own origin point. Next up, we have 3D cursor. This will make it so the 3D cursor, which is this red and white striped circle cursor in the center here, is now the reference point for our transforms. So now when I press R, you can see it's going to rotate around that 3D cursor. I'm going to press S to scale. It's also going to scale based on that 3D cursor as a reference point. This can be handy because obviously I could press Shift right click like we covered in the 3D cursor video to move my cursor, and now when I press R, you can see it's now going to rotate off that 3D cursor. If you want to learn more about moving the 3D cursor in different ways and how it can be useful, I highly recommend checking out that video. We also have this option called Active Element. Briefly, in a previous tutorial in the series, I mentioned about active objects and non-active selected objects. The active selected object will be the one which has the brightest highlight around it. In my case, is this white outline, but for some of you, it might be a bright yellow outline. The not-active selected object will have an orange outline. There's limitations to what you can and can't do with active and non-active selected objects, but the active selected object will determine a few things, and one of those things is the active element option here in Transform Pivot Point. What this means is the active object's origin point will become the pivot point for our transforms. So when I press S, for example, it's going to scale using the origin of our active selected object, which is our cylinder in this case, and when we rotate, is going to rotate off that origin point as well. To change our active selected object, I can shift left click the cube again, and that's not going to deselect it, but rather is going to change it to the active selected object. And now when I press R, you can see that now the cube is now the reference point for rotation and scale. If I was to shift left click active object, you can see it will deselect. I'll shift left click it again to make it active. Finally, the last one we have is bounding box center. When I press S, you can see it's going to scale it from the center. When I rotate it, it's also going to rotate it from the center. And no matter what my active object is, that will always be true. And yeah, that just about covers the transform pivot points. If you want to learn more, this video is part of a series of ongoing tutorials where I teach 3D modeling for absolute beginners and cover a lot of the fundamentals inside a Blender to support that. If you like my style of teaching and want to follow along, make sure to check out the playlist here, as I'll be adding videos daily, or if you're watching this in the future, all the videos might be out already. But with that, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.